Planet Dolan. From why the Earth is slowing down to why the sun hurts our eyes, we answer some of your most burning questions about life. I'm Danger Dolan, and I'm here to blow your mind.
Ladies and gentlemen, presenting to you live from the Planet Dolan HQ, the one, the only, the immaculate, the legendary, Nixium! Yeah! Oh, yep.
Wow. How could I ever top that display?
Shut up, peasant. I've had enough of your jokes. This time, I'm reading out the only parts people care about in these videos. And you know what? You can read out the leftovers.
Fine with me. I can't wait to hear some of that classic Nixium commentary. Oh boy! Excited. Chili Dog Dolan asks, if a neutron star happens after a supernova, would that mean a black hole would be a star too?
No, idiot. Black holes are too dark to be stars. What you're looking at is the chaotic aftermath of many battles against the ancient demigods, the sundered remnants of the universe hewn through supernova, and other things that you can't understand because you're dumb.
Ha! Huh, I can't believe how funny that was. You're killing it, dude.
Gosh, Dolan, aren't you supposed to be supporting me? I'm getting so many negative vibes from you, and I'm trying to do professional voice acting here. So be quiet.
Sure, Nixium. Anything I can do to help you, buddy. No, despite both forming during a supernova, a black hole is not considered a star. Neutron stars are the densest form of a star, but do not have the required mass to become a black hole. The black hole will form when the star is 3 times the mass of the sun. Also, not all black holes are formed during a supernova. Antixa TS asks, does moonlight actually exist?
Of course it does. How else are you supposed to see things at night? We invented the moon back in the 1980s so that we can save money on light bulbs and electricity.
But NASA flew to the moon in the 1960s. How would they do that if it didn't exist?
They flew there to start building it?
They flew to the moon to build the moon.
No. The moon was fake, but they built one and made it real, you fool.
Okay. No, the moon itself is not a source of light, as moonlight is mainly reflected light from the sun. Only 12% of the light that hits the moon is reflected back. Under such low light conditions, our eyes can't see with the same level of detail or color. This is why moonlight appears to be so different from direct sunlight. Ravenwolf14 asks, if the sun is so far away, why does it hurt my eyes when I look at it from Earth?
That's because you're weak. You need to schedule time in your day, every day, to train your eyes and just stare at the sun for at least 1 to 2 hours. You see, Tollop used to be a giant loser until he took my advice. And now he's nowhere near as refined as me. But at least he's not a total waste anymore.
It's not the actual rays of sunlight that hurt your eyes, although the ultraviolet light does damage the eyes if you look for too long. Instead, it's the pupils in our eyes that contract to let in less light. And as they adjust quickly to bright conditions, the muscles work harder to get as small as possible.
Hey, come here for a second. I need to talk to you.
I am literally good. I'm almost certainly okay to keep standing right here.
Fine. I didn't need you anyway.
The Green Book asks, how did airplanes get their name?
They got the ideas for the designs after seeing someone weird in the sky. Look, is that a bird? A plane? No, it's me, Nixium, Lord of the Dead, Devourer of Souls, Eternal Champion of the Unholy Abyss. Oh. Airplanes are just a total ripoff, and they owe me some extreme amounts of cash royalties for stealing my image. Yeah.
The word airplane comes from the French word aeroplane, which is derived from the Greek word for air and planos, meaning wandering. The word airplane originally only referred to the wing, since it is a plane, or flat surface, that is, moving through the air. Eventually came to refer to the entire craft.
Based on me.
Sure. It was you. Believable, mate.
Don't call me mate, friend.
Oh no, Nixium. I thought you were my bestie. Zhu Shen Girl asks, if the Earth has a lava center, then why isn't the Earth burning up from the inside out?
Well...
It's okay. I got this one. Haven't you guys ever been through summer? That's the Earth's core heating up. Pavements, a furnace, everyone's sweating. Can't possibly be anything else. Case closed.
No! That is the worst answer you could have possibly given! Just shut your rancid face, Dolan! Shoo! You suck!
Oh, my deepest apologies. What were you going to say?
Okay, well, what I was gonna say...
The Earth doesn't burn up from the inside, because pressure is playing a role, not just temperature. Even though the center is extremely hot, it is not under the right conditions to melt. There are pockets of magma, but overall the crust and layers make it difficult for heat to move outwards from the center. Also, the reaction that causes the heat is different to that of a star, and is not as hot. Ninja Knight 05 Productions asks, is the Earth's rotation actually slowing down?
Oh, that. Yeah, that's just the world dying because of all the decomposing souls choking the atmosphere. If it's a cloudy night and you look up into the sky, you can see the sparkling light show of a million tortured ghosts struggling to break free from the icy grip of eternal damnation. Oh, so romantic. I've taken all the Planet Dolan girls to see it. They all love it. But mostly me.
Yes, the Earth is gradually slowing down due to tidal friction with the Moon. The Moon's rotation is increasing as it slowly moves away from the Earth. In 100 years, a day will be 2 milliseconds longer, and billions of years from now, a day and a month are estimated to both last 47 days. SilverEdge 2006 asks, what flavor was the original bubblegum?
Gross! Bubblegum is the dumbest invention ever, and you should feel ashamed if you chew it. You know who made this trash? Those Japanese kawaii schoolgirls and weirdos like Andy Mations. Oh, it's disgusting. Get that filth away from me.
The first bubblegum, created by Walter Dimer of the Fleer Company in 1928, had a unique flavor that has been kept secret. Called Double Bubble, the gum likely contained a combination of natural and artificial fruit flavors to create a distinct bubblegum taste. The first successful chewing gum flavor was licorice. Nixium, I had a complaint from our staff. Apparently, you went to the artist's room and started screeching about bubblegum?
No, it didn't happen.
Okay. Because I was standing right here, and I heard it happen, and you did it like 20 seconds ago. Also, I saw you do it.
Well, I'm telling you that you've got the wrong guy. You just need to listen better.
Huh. Interesting. Ken Ironroad asks, what country made the first jet?
My country. It was me. Don't you get it? I am the first airplane. Me, Nixium, Lord of the Dead, Devourer.
I'm sorry.
Of the...
Could I just?
No. Shut up. I'm talking.
Please, come on.
No.
Germany was the first country to successfully fly a turbojet-powered aircraft in 1939.
No.
It was called Heinkelhe 178. This was despite the efforts of Englishman Frank Whittle, who originally developed the idea in 1928. The first commercial jetliner was the de Havilland Comet, which was made in the United Kingdom, had its first test flight in 1949.
I am never working with you again. You're suffocating me.
Could I just... No! Lily Pons 15 asks, is it possible for a blind person to get their vision back?
Of course it is. Stop being a whiny girl and just fix it yourself, tall op. You're not blind. You just need to reach inside your sockets like this. And you just pull them out like this. Well, there we go. Good as new.
Okay. Are you an actual psycho? Or are you just oblivious to the pain you cause others?
You guys are more than welcome.
Yes, there have been successful cases of a blind person regaining their sight. These resulted from a variety of experimental procedures such as stem cell surgery. One such procedure uses glasses with tiny cameras attached that send signals to the retinal implant in the patient's eye. However, these only restore partial sight, allowing the person to make out shapes. Becky asks, why do tropical cyclones spin in opposite directions in the northern and southern hemispheres?
That's because people on the other side of the world are wrong. Take Dolan. He's from Austin, Aurelia. Over there, when they flush a toilet, a crocodile will pop out. It's terrifying.
Oh my god. Really?
How do you survive, though? I really don't understand your Australian CO dingo laws. Do you people even have water? You're so primitive.
Cyclones spin counterclockwise in the northern hemisphere and clockwise in the southern hemisphere due to the Coriolis effect. This occurs because of the rotation of the Earth, which prevents the air from moving in a straight line, deflecting it either left or right, depending on the hemisphere.
Okay, hold on. I've been thinking. Maybe, just maybe, you would have more of an audience if we just renamed the show to Superplanet Nixium.
Not even slightly.
Or Nixium Presents, the Nixium Show, featuring his fans. That would be you.
You know what? That's a great idea.
Yeah?
No.
Oh.
Anyway, that's it. Thanks for watching. Have a good one.